To be perfectly candid, one of the great challenges in covering the Trump era has been listening to public figures telling stark lies and trying to discern whether the individual is cynically, purposefully misrepresenting the truth or is misinformed and possibly incapable of understanding the facts involved or possibly suffering from some sort of psychological issue. The president delivered a speech on video this week that he billed as the most important speech he's ever made, and what followed was 46 minutes of lies and conspiracy theories. The same evidence-free claims of election fraud that have resulted in the Trump legal team and their allies, the gang that couldn't sue straight, having more than 30 court cases rejected or dropped as of now. On Friday evening alone, courts in five different battleground states, Arizona, Michigan, Minnesota, Nevada, and Wisconsin, five different states slapped down efforts by Trump and his allies to overturn the election results. A judge in Maricopa County, Arizona wrote, quote, "The court finds no misconduct, no fraud, and no effect on the outcome of the election." So the new strategy, because they're failing in the courts, is pushing governors and state legislatures to disenfranchise millions of legal American voters in states that President-elect Biden won, and sending Trump supporters to the Electoral College to steal the election. Based on the same deranged claims, here's one Trump witness in Michigan with Rudy Giuliani this week telling a story that a judge had already found, quote, simply not credible. Here she is attacking a Republican state legislator.
My question here is, why we're not seeing the poll book off by 30,000 votes? That's not the case.
What do you guys do? Take it and do something crazy to it?
I'm just saying the numbers are not off by 30,000 votes. So
I know what I saw.
That they're filling in.
I know what I saw, and I signed something saying that if I'm wrong, I can go to prison. Okay. Did you?
President Trump just praised that witness on Twitter, and frankly, there are millions of Americans being misled by the president and his sycophants on Capitol Hill and in MAGA media that these clownish, discredited efforts are real and legitimate. And now some of those folks who have been misled are threatening violence against these officials who have been honestly running the elections. Take a listen to Republican state election official Gabriel Sterling with the Georgia Secretary of State's office.
Someone's gonna get hurt, someone's gonna get shot, someone's gonna get killed. And it's not right.
It isn't. None of this is acceptable. But to be frank, President Trump has been pushing lies and conspiracy theories for years that have made life more dangerous for all kinds of Americans. He's stoked hate against blacks and Latinos and Muslims and Jews and Asian Americans, against women, against judges, against Democrats, against Republicans who disagreed with him, against journalists, against entertainers. This did not just start on November 3rd. It turns out when a major political party coddles and enables and supports public figures who lie rapaciously and incessantly, and also tolerate threats against those who challenge those lies, that storm of lies and indecency is strengthened and unleashed, and it cannot be controlled. And ultimately, the reason, cynicism or ignorance or illness, does not matter as much as that result. Look, in his racist campaign against immigrants, President Trump would often read the lyrics of a song that told the story of a tender-hearted woman who finds a half-frozen snake and nurses it back to health, only to fall victim to the snake's predatory nature.
Oh, shut up, silly woman, said the reptile with a grin. You knew damn well I was a snake before you took me in.
As Republican officials deal with these horrors of a president whose hideous lies are putting their election hopes in Georgia at risk, and more importantly, tragically, unacceptably, horrifyingly, even putting lives at risk, it has to be asked, did you not know who this man was when you took him in? Thanks for spending your Sunday morning with us. The news continues next.